What's up, guys? Out here with kind of a new beast today. This is actually my old Creighton, my kind of, you know, V2 kind of home-built Creighton. Had actually converted from my original Outcast a couple years ago, but anyway, now that I got the V4 Creighton, I decided there wasn't really a need for basically two of the same trucks. So what I did with this is, since I've got the V4 Creighton and the V3 Talion, I kind of converted this to more of a classic Talion, you know, with the Creighton towers and shocks, but more set up like an old Talion. Which I've always wanted one of those, but you know, since the V3s came out, I went ahead and picked up one of those. But anyway, I kind of fitted my old C10 that I used to have on my V3 to this platform here. I did put on Typhon hubs. Basically, what I did is I took my V4 Typhon and I swapped the all the hubs so I could truckify it, and I can make this more of a Talion base. And I put the shocks on the inner holes on the towers just for better handling. I'm kind of converting all my trucks that way. I like how they handle and overall stability like that, and jumping and all that. So what I had to do though in the front hub right here, in order for this Badland to clear without any kind of rubbing at all, I had to put three shims like you would put in your diff case over here, the little outer diff shims. I put in small three shims on each hub, on each hex there, before I put the tire on, and it spins free with no rubbing at all. So that ended up working out good. And also, I did have the Hobby Star power plant in it, but I ended up having the whole system kind of crapped out on me. I mean, I've had it in there for a while. It's taking a lot of abuse. Right now, Purple Power kind of donated her heart, for a little heart transplant for this bash. I got the BLX system back in it, which actually I'm starting to lean more towards the stock system. I mean, it's got all the power you ever need. Keeps the truck light. The motor's a lot lighter, you know, than a big 4092s. Got a 17 tooth pinion on here, so I'm gonna go ahead and run it like this, kind of, you know, in an Italian form, and see how it goes. All right, guys, let's see what's up. Oh god, it's kind of a blind landing down there, the way that hill is. Hey guys, this thing handles so much better. I killed the power. Ah, she bounced. Thank you. Oh, oh man, looks like that. I took some body mounts with it. Sure did. It looks like they just came unscrewed from the tower. Let me go fix that real quick. That was a hard hit. Uh-oh. That doesn't look good. Ooh, that landing took a rod end with it. That's actually one of the yeah, that was one of the stock ones. That's one of the ones I hadn't replaced to the Nero end yet. All right, I just replaced that rod end, but unfortunately I'm out of the Nero HDs, so I just used a another stock one that I had. It's probably not gonna last very long, but hopefully it'll get by for another couple jumps and I got to get out of here. Oh man, that sounded rough. Right there in midair, started doing it. I wasn't sure if I had enough power to spin her around. Sounds like maybe the motor mount came loose. Oh yeah, definitely got a shift in the mount there. All right, I'm gonna have to go ahead and call it. I gotta get out of here. It's kind of getting, it's dinner time. Anyway, it's pretty fun. Little Talion, classic Talion creation here. I mean, she did good. I'm gonna have to get some new body mounts for it too. I mean, guys, these landings are really hard out here, especially on this gravel when you're doing this kind of vertical airs. Anyway, all right, it was a blast. Until next time, RC Dude 81. Peace out.